Hello friends, I welcome you all to this video. We are with the 27th topic from our chapter Power Spectrum Estimation, the fourth chapter in our subject Advanced Digital Signal Processing. So for the power spectrum estimation concerning the discrete time random processes, we are understanding the various techniques. First of all, the non-parametric and then the parametric here. After completion of the non-parametric techniques listed as the periodogram, the modified periodogram, Bartlett's method, Welch's method, Blackman-Tukey approach, along with the other two, those are separate from the non-parametric approach, minimum variance spectrum estimation and maximum entropy method. Just now we have started with the another approach that is called as the parametric power spectrum estimation, and the first prominent technique from thereupon we have just now addressed, that it is the autoregressive spectrum estimation. So in this video, let us take a problem based on to this spectrum estimation for the special type of the discrete time random process called as the autoregressive AR process here. Hence we have the topic titled problem regressive spectrum estimation. So let us see what is the problem statement and how we can have its spectrum estimation for the given details in the problem statement. So let us begin with the topic. So here we can start with our topic problem, autoregressive spectrum estimation. So very first of all, we have been provided the problem statement that starts with the estimated autocorrelation sequence of a random process denoted x of n for the lags k is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4 are denoted here. Rx of 0 is equal to 2, Rx of 1 is equal to 1, Rx of 2 is equal to 1. Next to that we have Rx of 3 is equal to 0.5 and Rx of 4 is equal to 0. We have been asked to have the estimation of the power spectrum for the random process x of n for the following case, that it is x of n is AR2 process here. So we have been provided in this problem statement. The problem statement is completed here. The input random process is denoted as x of n, and this is basically of AR2 type here. And here we have been provided the values of the coefficients into the autocorrelation sequence for the lags k is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So Rx of 0 is equal to 2, Rx of 1 is equal to 1, Rx of 2 is equal to 1, Rx of 3 is equal to 0.5, Rx of 4 is equal to 0. With this given information, we have been asked to estimate the power spectrum of x of n. So as in the previous video, we have seen that the estimation of the power spectrum for the random process of AR2 type or simply AR type is represented as capital P cap suffix AR as a function of e to the power j omega. So it is to be determined for the given discrete time random process of autoregressive type here. So let us find the solution to it. So here we begin for part that the second order AR model, if we are given AR2 random process in the problem statement, so we can have the determination by solution to the normal equations like this. As in the previous video, while understanding the power spectrum estimation for autoregressive process, we have this type of the equation, and now the 2 by 2 order autocorrelation sequence matrix here, it is represented with the first row Rx of 0, Rx of 1, in the second row Rx of 1, Rx of 0. So this autocorrelation sequence matrix that is usually represented capital R suffix X, X being the random process, it is to be multiplied to the column matrix holding the coefficients A of 1 and A of 2, in general A of K here. So this is equal to minus of, we have Rx of 1, Rx of 2 in the column matrix here. Now we have been given the autocorrelation sequence coefficient values here. So upon substitution from the given details, we get this equation to the new form. Here we write the first matrix as the first row elements are 2, 1, and the second row are 1, 2. Whereas A of 1 and A of 2 matrix is the same here for multiplication to the earlier autocorrelation matrix. And the RHS upon multiplication of these two matrices is to result into the minus of the column matrix having the first row element 1, second row element 1 here. So upon requirement of the determination of the unknown that it is the matrix of A of K here, we can get it onto the left hand side as it is and have the manipulation with respect to the other two matrices, those have the coefficient values substituted. We get it to the form, the matrix we have A of 1, A of 2 in the column way is equal to minus of 1 by 3 in multiplication to the matrix column 1. So it is holding the elements into the first row 1 and the second row it is 1 here. Now as we know in the model representation for the autoregressive process, there it is the requirement of the model error that is usually represented by epsilon. So for this case we represent it as epsilon suffix 2 here. So 2 is the value of p, epsilon suffix p, the general way we represent. So this can be calculated as rx of 0 added to a of 1 in multiplication to rx of 1. Further added to, we have a of 2 in multiplication to rx of 2 here. So upon substitution of the values from the grievance problem statement, we get it to the value 4 divided by 3. Now these values, those we have determined, can be made into the use, and the model with respect to this AR process can be shown into the Fourier domain like this. So the mathematical expression here, it is for capital A as a function of e to the power j omega, that is equal to 1 minus 1 by 3 times e to the power minus j omega minus 1 by 3 times e to the power minus twice j omega. So here it is the representation by the use of the Fourier in the frequency domain here. We can also make the use of Z domain to represent the same. Now having the knowledge of the modeling error epsilon suffix 2 and this A as a function of e to the power j omega that is to be put into the denominator for calculation of the mod square, we get the required estimate of the power spectrum for the given autoregressive type of the random process that it is represented. Capital P cap suffix x as a function of e to the power j omega is equal to, in the numerator we put 4 by 3 and in the denominator we put mod square of 1 minus 1 by 3 into e to the power minus j omega minus 1 by 3 times e to the power we have j omega here. So this completes the solution to the required question here. And with this, we are completed with this topic, problem based on the autoregressive spectrum estimation. So by the next lecture, we shall continue into the same chapter to conclude the power spectrum estimation. Thank you.